Good morning. Thank you so much for being here. This is such an exciting time for us. We're all really excited about the workshop. Welcome. Again, I'd like to say a huge thank you to the speakers who have come from so far away to be here with us for the next couple of days. Thank you so much for making the effort to be here with us. And thank you for all of the participants for joining us for this exciting 2 days. Welcome to Germany, welcome to Bonn, and welcome to the Institute for Science and Ethics. My name is Professor Aimee van Wynsberghe. I am the founder of the Bonn Sustainable AI Lab, and I'm also the director of the Institute for Science and Ethics. And I am the Alexander von Humboldt Professor for the Applied Ethics of Artificial Intelligence. It's a long one, yeah? So before I get into sort of the inspiration of the workshop and do my little 5-minute spiel, I'd like to do a round of thank yous to the organizers of the next couple of days. So Jahazia, where are you? Jahazia, can you stand up? José and Laura, please stand up. A round of applause for these three. They have done an incredible job with the organization of this event. We've had to arrange so many international flights and hotels and trains and whatnot, and the three of them did an incredible job with this. And as I had mentioned last night when we had a welcome for the speakers, all three of them have not even been here for 6 months. So all of this was put together in 3 to 4 months, which is absolutely incredible. So thank you all for your efforts. Then the rest of the lab, can you please stand up? I do this all the time. So these are the researchers at the Bonn Sustainable AI Lab, and they all contributed as well. And Marcus and Luca, who are behind the cameras, they all contributed in many ways to the organization of the workshop, both in conceptual and helping with the lead organizing team. So thank you, all of you. And I also need to say thank you to the Humboldt Foundation. They have provided us with the resources to be able to run such a workshop. So thank you, Humboldt. Thank you, Humboldt. Okay, so just a quick kind of introduction. As I said, my name is Aimee van Wynsberghe. I'm originally from Canada. I actually started my studies in cell biology, so I'm not a classically trained philosopher or ethicist. And while I was studying cell biology, I also worked at a robotics institute. And this is where we were training surgeons how to use surgical robots. And the way that we evaluated the technology, the way that we said, yes, this is good or this is not good, was really the efficiency of the procedure. So how quickly could the surgeon perform, and how many errors did the surgeon encounter? I'd like to be clear, we were not experimenting on human subjects. These were dry lab experiments, because we're on camera. I have to make sure that I cover all of my bases, yeah? But at this time, I was sort of... Yeah, I was questioning, again, I wasn't studying ethics, but I was questioning how we were evaluating the technology, that it was really this sort of narrow way of looking at the technology and not the broader picture. What was the nurse's experience? What was the surgeon's actual experience rather than just the speed at which they could perform the surgery? So my interest, this was 20 years ago, and that's when my interest in sort of looking at the bigger picture when it comes to evaluating technology sort of began, the seed began to grow. And now what I'm doing here at the University of Bonn is once again, looking at this bigger picture, the broader picture when it comes to artificial intelligence. So not just once we've created the technology, now what happens, what can go wrong, but really looking at the ethical issues throughout the entire development chain. So from the very idea generation to where are the minerals coming from, how are the algorithms actually being trained, the energy consumption, all the way to the electronic waste, and where is that going? So very much the broader picture. Here at the lab, our focus is on sustainable artificial intelligence, what that means, and actually what that should mean. So we're not trying to suggest that the current status quo or the situation that we're in is something that we should sustain, right, to maintain. We're also looking at this idea of repairing. So looking at things that are broken in the procurement chain of artificial intelligence, and what is it that we need to repair? And we have these two branches that we look at, yeah? So we have AI for sustainability and the sustainability of artificial intelligence. And with this one branch, this is how can we use AI to achieve the SDGs? How can we use AI to mitigate the climate crisis and whatnot? Or yesterday we heard about wonderful research being done. How can we use AI to empower youth to sort of expand green opportunities, right? So AI for something. But we're also looking at the sustainability of AI. And like I had mentioned before, all of these environmental consequences. So the carbon emissions when we're talking about training, the energy consumption, the water usage, the land usage, the minerals, the mining conditions in these minerals, and then, of course, the electronic waste and where this is going. So this breadth of ethical issues that we want to focus on, and of course, also questioning, should we have these two branches or must they come together? Must we say that you can only call something sustainable AI if you are using it for sustainable purposes and you are also addressing the sustainability of artificial intelligence? So each researcher at the lab has a different focus, and you'll see in the foyer and also behind us here, we have these beautiful banners where you can read about all of the research that they're doing, and they're all here, so feel free to grab them on a coffee break and ask them more about their research. So the inspiration for the workshop, about a year and a half ago, I had an incredible experience where I visited the Arctic, and I was in one of the smallest, oldest indigenous communities in Tuktoyaktuk. I hope I said that right, Tuktoyaktuk. And I was struck by the different branches, how the different branches were approached. And on the one hand, the community was looking at how they could use artificial intelligence, natural language processing models, to preserve their traditional languages, right? Because the youth weren't speaking those languages anymore. So was it possible to use such a model, to create such a model, to help keep this language alive, if you will? So this idea of AI for sustainability in a certain respect. At the same time, the community that I was visiting, it was amazing to watch how they were living through the climate crisis, that they had lost so many homes or had to move the homes because the water would come up and wash the homes away. These are a coastal community in the Arctic. And how they managed to survive in the unpredictable weather conditions that were a result of the climate crisis. And their philosophy, their mantra, was really this idea that you only take from the earth what you need. And of course, for them, in the situation that they were in, they didn't have a plethora of resources because many of them had been wiped out. But it was very much a part of them to only take from the earth what you need, to preserve the earth for the current community as well as for future generations. And I thought, wow, what would an AI strategy or an AI policy or an AI ethics look like if that was our starting point? If that was the first idea that we had when we were drafting such a policy. Then in the last year, I had the pleasure of working with researchers from Ghana. I'm looking for Doji? Hey. Doji and Modesta, I think hasn't joined us yet. These are two researchers who won prestigious scholarships to come and work with us for the last year. And we also have Jahaziel, who's on a scholarship with us this year. And coming from the University of Ghana, they introduced our lab to the idea of Ubuntu, to the ideas of Ubuntu. And, you know, this focus on community. And so then the idea, of course, came up, what would an AI strategy or an AI ethics look like if that was the starting point, or if that was part of the starting point? This focus on community, as well as this focus on not taking more from the earth than what we actually need. So this workshop is about raising awareness. It's about being very explicit and clear that the global AI ethics debate is one that is very much Eurocentric at the current moment. That doesn't mean it will stay that way, but it is currently very Eurocentric. These are the ethical traditions that underpin all of the AI ethics principles, that underpin all of the strategies. And many of these strategies are now being brought to other countries that have different ethical traditions. And so we have to ask the question again, is this another form of colonialism, if you will? We are taking our ideas and enforcing them on other communities that don't subscribe to the same ethical traditions. So in the next couple of days, I want to raise awareness of the other non-Eurocentric, non-European views, their richness and their depth, how significant they are, and what they can mean for the global AI ethics debate, as well as just the global AI discourse. And excuse me, what a strategy might look like, or what an AI ethics policy might look like, if these were the guiding views, if these were our starting points. I had the opportunity to visit the University of Saskatchewan in Saskatoon.
Yeah, what up, Dylan?
And they have a wonderful research group on Indigenous studies. And it was made very clear and brought to my attention the problem or the dilemma that there are many Western researchers who go to Indigenous communities, extract the knowledge, extract the ideas, and bring them back to a European or a Western context without offering something for the communities that they have taken these things from. So I'd like to be very clear that I am aware of that tension, aware of that risk, and this workshop is not meant to be this kind of extractivism, this kind of taking ideas and then what can we do with it. Instead, I want this to be a coming together of ideas. I want to think in the next couple of days how we can work in harmony together. Yeah, to shape what a future discourse in AI ethics might look like and how we, as researchers in this room, can put this new vision on the stage, can raise awareness of it, and can actually create some momentum to make some change. So that's it for me. Welcome again. Thank you so much for being here. And before we get into the first speaker, I'd like to invite Jahazil and José to come to the podium to give you a bit of details in terms of the practicalities, how the next couple of days will work. So again, thank you so much for being here and enjoy.
Well, hey everyone, once again, thank you so much for being here. Just some housekeeping then. We're gonna have talks of like about 40, 45 minutes and then plus 15 minutes of Q&A. So, during the conversation, please feel make sure you take the notes so you don't forget your questions. And our idea for both today and tomorrow is that our discussion will be split in three parts. The first will be more generally on the discussion between AI and colonialism, maybe digital colonialism, and different intersections that this theme has. So we're going to have people talking about the relationship between colonialism and race in Latin America, which is the topic of Davison. We're going to have Modesta talking about Afrofeminist perspectives on this issue. And Samuel will also bring us, which will be the first presenter of today, information on an Afroethical framework for AI. Then we're going to discuss, focus on Indigenous ethics during the afternoon today. And tomorrow, we're going to see this in practice, how projects are being dealt with to promote Indigenous-led AI. And so now very practical stuff. We're having microphones for the questions. These are not supposed to, like, as you are seeing here, they're not supposed to, the sound's not supposed to come out of a sound system. It will be just for YouTube purposes. And after this morning, we're gonna have a lunch where we can all like chat and discuss more about what we are working on. So yeah, thank you so much. Thank you once again, Aimee. Thank you so much, Jahazio and Laura, for the collaboration, and thank the lab, and thank you all for being here and making this possible. Enjoy.